In this lesson, we'll discuss how the dimension theorem applies to matrices. The theorem states that if we have a matrix, let's say A, and it has n columns, then the rank of A plus the nullity of A is equal to n. In addition, every column either has a leading one or corresponds to a parameter. So with that being said, question one reads, let's say we have a matrix A and it's 5 by 6, so 5 rows by 6 columns, and it has a rank of 3. What is the nullity A, the rank of the transpose of A, and the nullity of the transpose of A? In case you forgot, the transpose of a matrix means to interchange the rows and the columns of the matrix. So in our case here, it's 5 by 6, the transpose will be 6 by 5. So let's begin with the nullity. We can use the following relationship where the rank of A plus the nullity of A is equal to n. The rank is 3 plus the nullity of A, which I'll call null A, is equal to, in our case, 6. Rearranging, we should end up with the nullity of A is equal to 6 minus 3, therefore it's 3. This means that this matrix would have 3 parameters, or in other words, 3 variables without leading ones after placing it in row echelon form. Next, we need to find the rank of the transpose of A. The transpose of A will be 6 by 5. And there's a theorem that states that the rank of a matrix is equal to the rank of its transpose. And the reason for that is because the row space of a transpose of a matrix is just the column space of that matrix, which has the same dimension as the row space of that matrix. So let's write that down, that the rank of A is equal to the rank of A transpose. So that answers this part. It's equal to 3. Now to find the nullity, we can go back to this formula. We already know the rank of the transpose, it's 3, plus now the nullity of the transpose is equal to, this time, 5. Remember, that's our new column. And if we rearrange, we should end up with the nullity of A transpose is equal to 5 minus 3, which is 2. Let's move on to question 2. The question reads, find the number of parameters in the general solution of the matrix A times the column vector X is equal to 0 if the matrix A is 8 by 6 and has a rank of 5. Now keep in mind that when they ask for the number of parameters, they're actually looking for the nullity of that matrix. So we can use the same relationship as before, where the rank of A plus the nullity of A is equal to n, and we can rearrange. Let me write that down. So the rank of A plus null of A is equal to the number of columns, which in our case is 6, the rank is 5, 5 plus this unknown null of A is equal to 6. If we rearrange, we should end up with the nullity of A is equal to 1. The null of A is equal to 1, and that's our answer. Finally, let's say we have a matrix that's 7 by 11, and what can we say about the maximum rank and minimum nullity? For this, you'll need to know the maximum value of a rank theorem, which states that if a matrix A is an m by n matrix, then the rank of that matrix can never exceed the minimum of m and n. So with that being said, the maximum rank can be 7, because we have 7 rows. Max rank of our matrix A can be 7. And if we reuse the relationship above, where rank of A plus null of A is equal to the number of columns, in our case 11. If we rearrange and bring this over where we set it as 7, 7 take away from 11 gives us 4. So the nullity of A must be greater or equal to 4. And there you have it. 3 examples on how to apply the dimension theorem for matrices.